glory.
Yes.
No matter what. The porter, not knowing who belonged to who, would step out of the way. While each shepherd would line up and come at random times, not necessarily all at one time. It wasn't the porter's responsibility to count the sheep. It wasn't the porter's responsibility to do anything but to guard the sheep, keep the wolves out. Come on now. That all the sheep were in place so that their own shepherd could come and pick them up. Are y'all listening to me? Y'all ain't gonna like this. I wonder today that if you are his sheep and he called your voice, y'all ain't gonna say nothing. Do you know his voice?
Hallelujah.
Didn't matter if there was little black sheep, little white sheep. Didn't matter if there was fat sheep, skinny sheep. Didn't matter. Every sheep knew their shepherd's voice. Can you imagine the visual of that?
Yeah.
Hello, sheep. 90 keep their head down. 10 look up. Is that my shepherd? They nudge, though. They go, our shepherd. Y'all ain't saying nothing. 1,000 sheep in a sheepfold. 900 don't look up. Only 100 look up. Don't say nothing to me. What is it, glory to God, that those sheep knew about that shepherd? The rest of them kept eating, the rest of them kept drinking, grazing, sleeping. But when that particular shepherd got to the sheepfold, 100, the same 100 he dropped off, looked up and said, wait a minute, you gonna come on? That's our shepherd. And when a sheep hears the shepherd's voice, they don't negotiate. Shepherd and his 100 look up. digress for. I don't understand how people can go all over everybody's church and be in everybody's church, all up and down in everything. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing. I don't get quiet. I know my shepherd's voice. I know my under shepherd's voice. I know my sheep. I was talking to some of them yesterday. And they was hugging and kissing. I said, I still know my sheep. You eat in other people's pastures. But I still know my sheep. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing. Hello, somebody. Touch your neighbor and say, touch your neighbor on the other side and say, sure enough. See, I know my sheep, and I know you know my voice. Because I know every way you go, you sound like me. You act like me. You preach like me. You pray like me. You sing like me. My sheep know my voice. Focus now on relationship. Somebody say relationship. My sheep. Now watch this. Watch this. I'm going to go somewhere. Is that right? Can I go someplace right quick?
Okay.
Amen. Hallelujah. Go to Ephesians chapter number 2. Let's go to Ephesians chapter number 2. Praise God. Ephesians chapter number 2. And I want to just talk a little bit more about this relationship. See, in Ephesians chapter number 2, we discover, praise God, in verses 18 and 19, that there is a general revelation of God. There is a general revelation of God. Somebody said there is a general revelation of God. Say it again. There's a general revelation of God. All right, now watch this. Watch this, what it says here. It says, but there is also a specific revelation of God. Verse 18 says, for through him, Jesus Christ, we both have access by one spirit to the Father. Verse 19, therefore now you are no longer what? Strangers, come on, read with me, and what? Foreigners, but what? Fellow citizens with the saints and members of the household of God. Amen. So there is a general revelation of God, but then there is a specific revelation of God that only belongs to his family.
Wow, that's good.
See, strangers know God. Psalms 19 says, the heavens declare God.
Yes.
The stars and the firmaments, they declare God.
Yes.
And everything, all in creation, declares the glory of God. See, that's general revelation. Somebody say general revelation.
Yes.
You don't have to be a sheep of God to appreciate the sun or the stars. And that's why people take cruises. Because they enjoy the general revelation of God. They like being on the boats and watching all that water. And there's a whole lot of people on these boats. And they just appreciate what? The general revelation of God. They're not his sheep. They don't hear his voice. But they respect the general revelation of God. Okay, now let me go on this side. They look at the moon and say, ooh, look at that moon. And they look at the trees and the cherry blossoms. They say, ooh, isn't it pretty? They go to Washington, D.C. and see the blossoms. They go to Holland, Michigan. And they go to Frankenmuth. They go all these places. Why? Because they reverence a general revelation of God. Because although they think that they're honoring the moon or the sun, no, it's God's creation.
Yes.
And God, the Bible says in Psalm 19, that the heavens declare me. The moon, the star, they declare who God is.
Yes.
But they can't hear his voice. They cannot hear his voice. They can appreciate his creation. They can appreciate these oceans and land and Pacific and all these things that God has created. They appreciate. They like going fishing. They like pulling fish out of his water.
Wow.
They, 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 They love being out on a nice moonlit night with the one they love. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing. They like what God has created around us. Come on now, they like flowers. You see people just, you know, like to plant flowers and dig in the ground. They like that. They like to see flowers grow, but they can't hear his voice. Even though when the flower is blooming, it's declaring the glory of God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. They like planting corn and okra and tomatoes. They like that. They like that. But they cannot hear his voice. There is a general revelation of God, but only the family of God have access to his voice. Says Ephesians 2:19 says we have access.
Yes.
We have access.
Yes.
Those of us that have been born of God, who have made Jesus our Savior, yes, that we have access to the Father through the Holy Spirit. Yes. That we don't just have to celebrate the fish that's in his water. Yes. We don't just have to clap our hands when we see the stars twinkling and the moon glowing and the sun shining. That we actually can hear the voice of the one that created it all. No, listen what I'm saying.
No,
because he only reveals himself to his sheep.
Yes.
don't read his Bible, you don't pick up his word every day. How strong is your relationship with Jesus? If you're not in this Bible on a daily basis, because this is his voice,
yes,
then for real, how strong is your relationship with Jesus? You can go days and weeks and, you know, pick up this Bible to read this Bible. How intimate is the conversation between you and Jesus? Because this is the vocabulary of God. It's a lot of sheep in the sheepfold. We can't play with this. You have a general revelation of God, but do you have a personal revelation?
Right.
I live around a lot of people, we work around a lot of people that use God. Yeah, God said that. Yeah, God did. And yeah, God, I saw God, yeah. But ask him, what did he say to you? I remember when I stopped watching Christian TV. Because I don't want to hear what God said to you. And slowly but surely, it began to dwindle away from me. That I caught myself about a month ago, Pastor Val, and I said, my TV is off most of the time. It used to be on, listen, Christian TV all day. I would leave it on when I left. And I would raise my children up with Christian music in the house, because we didn't have a lot of Christian TV at that time. It was on the radio. But you could not walk in my house and not hear something that was quote unquote religious. I would feel the atmosphere with the word or the music or with a lot of things. And I can't really tell you exactly when I stopped listening to these people. I can't even tell you when HGTV became my primary television station. Y'all ain't saying that. That I'll flip it on and it's just okay. Every now and again, I'd love to hear Mr. Old Stephen. Every now and again, I'm flipping Bishop Jason saying a little something, something. But I've come to the maturity that I want to hear his voice.
Yes.
So I go back to what I said to you in the beginning. It's his delight to talk to you.
Yeah.
That he's not just talking to me, but he will talk to you.
Yeah.
And when he talks to you, your only response is to follow. You like a lot more backtrack music. I don't need to pray with backtrack music.
Lay out!
Lay out!
Say it, Jesus. done with this one. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith to the church. He's talking to his church. He's talking to his sheep. When you do something that he's not pleased with, he talks to you.
Yes, he does.
You can't tell me that you still got them habits because he ain't talked to you. Now, here's the thing. Either he didn't talk to you because you're not his, or number two, you heard him and you didn't know it was him because you got to hear and discern because it's a lot of voices. You ain't still smoking because God has spoken to you. You smoke because you have said to yourself, I'm a smoke. You ain't hustling because you ain't heard him say, that ain't what I want you to do. You hustle because you like hustle. And whatever the hustle is, still in the play. Somebody said to me the other day, I'm after this money. I'm after this money. I said, good luck with that. Because door number one may be money, but door number two could be death.
Yeah.
Y'all don't say nothing to me.
Yeah.
What would it profit a man to gain the what whole world that you want? See, you gotta hear a voice. You gotta hear a voice. Because there is a way that seems right to a man, but there ain't no mistake. You got to hear his voice.
Hallelujah.
I would have died. I would have fainted had I not heard his voice. See, that's the difference between sheep. They know they ain't wrong. They know they're codependent on that shepherd. They know they gotta rely on that shepherd to guide them and lead them. They know they ain't wrong. They know that they have to rely on the shepherd's voice. We think that because we reach a certain age that we get the right to do what we want to do. Go back to that verse in 27. Go back to it and circle the first word, say, my sheep know my voice. A stranger, they don't follow. And sometimes you're your own nemesis. Because you think that you can do what you want to do. Because you can vote now. You can go to the army now. You can buy alcohol legally now. You think you got a right to you. But once you have been found Christ as your Savior, and you've been baptized into the body of Christ by the Holy Spirit, you are no longer yours. You are his sheep. He is our shepherd. We are the sheep of his pasture. He guides us. He leads us. And you no longer have a right to yourself. Independent sheep.
inside.
Preach the word to you, but have you heard his voice in the middle of this? I was talking to someone about the convocation, and I said, Lord, let him hear your voice. Let him hear your voice. I was just praying to the Lord just for 3 o'clock. Lord, let him hear your voice. We do things because we don't hear his voice. And we don't do things. Speak to your sheep. And those that are not yours, give them the burden to become your sheep. Through the same